Well, I first encountered the very first landmine survivor in 1989 in Vietnam. And basically since then, I've been trying to show through photography how these survivor lives and survive.
Personally, I think that we have achieved a lot with the implementation of the Mine Ban Treaty. We saved a lot of lives and limbs first. We cleared a lot of land. We destroyed a lot of stocks of landmines. And I think that this treaty is working on the field. It made life of people that were injured and the families of those that are killed and the communities that are affected better. So I think that this treaty, I'm sure that this treaty is working.
I guess the Mine Ban Treaty has been a very powerful treaty to save lives of many people in many countries suffering from the mine problem. Unfortunately, a new year is starting in the life of the treaty, and we still have problems in many, many countries, especially in our part of the world, in the Middle East.
Ans après l'adoption du traité d'Ottawa interdisant l'utilisation des mines antipersonnelles, nous pouvons considérer que cet instrument juridique international a atteint à ce jour une étape de maturité.
We already have 162 state parties to the convention, and I call for all of them to complete the job.
I hope that we can reach the goal of Afghanistan free of mine by 2023.
This is so important step to clear affected area, work in my race education, and the most relevant is the victim assistance effort. I expect the job to be finished at 2025 and celebrate together my free world.
We hope that all countries will come on board of the treaty, and especially look forward to the United States joining and getting the job done.
We hope Sri Lanka will be a state party to the Mine Ban Convention very soon. We are hopeful that before 2025, whole world going to be mine-free world. This is the dream. We can achieve this dream before 2025.
For humanitarian reasons, we should be able to engage with all armed groups in order to educate them on the impact of the anti-personnel landmines or other similar explosives, which are affecting daily many civilians. So there is an urgent need to continue to engage armed groups today. And then we have our support, which is the norm established by Ottawa Convention.